toward the end of last year of 2019, did some research with my colleague Jim Nail. We partnered on a wave, which is essentially a vendor evaluation on the cross-channel video advertising platform space, where video is just sort of sight, sound, motion advertising, right? And we were looking at all of these different companies that were trying to help sort of piece together planning and buying and to a certain degree measurement for brands, right? Giving them a set of capabilities that allows them to better tie together their sort of disparate video strategies and spends. And that was a super fascinating, if maybe a little early to the market, kind of piece of research. Now I'm looking at, hey, no big deal, the future of advertising, which is, you know, a very big and open question, of which clearly television and video advertising is a huge part. So taking a kind of 3 to 5 year outlook and thinking about consumers and publishers and advertisers who are the most important constituents in the advertising ecosystem. Everything else is sort of supporting them, and how kind of out of balance those relationships have gotten, and how we sort of restore balance to advertising where consumers are less inclined to want to explicitly avoid or step away from advertising, because that's not good for anybody. So what are the big forces that are shaping advertising as it looks today, and what are the big forces that are going to continue to shape it? And things like privacy and consumer data access, the infrastructure where in digital it was the cookie, what has it become? Ad format innovation, the walled gardens, right? These big trends that are incredibly powerful in shaping what it looks like. And, you know, in the context of the Beet Retreat, there's, I think, some really interesting questions to be asked about what that means for the television industry, you know, where so much of the conversation now is around the use of data and household level targeting and hyper-personalization and being more relevant. How do we as an industry not make some of the mistakes that the overall ad industry has made in the past that got us to a place where we have things like real concern over the use of data and real concern over how that data moves around and gets transacted? How do we not create problems in the television industry that could lead to a backlash that we all want to avoid? So how do we work together? The question of how this is playing out, you know, as you release a piece of research that's looking at this notion of cross-channel and video and television, or what happens when you put something like that out there, I would say the response has been slightly more muted than you would hope, but maybe not more muted than you would expect, which is to say this idea of marrying different video strategies together is still pretty nascent. Mm-hmm. Right? This idea that you could be thinking about reach and frequency holistically, not just on a certain screen or in a certain format, is still pretty new. So I found a couple of people, Jim and I found a couple of people in the research that were saying things like, yes, we think of our video strategy holistically, but that still isn't really the norm. And I think the capabilities still need a lot of development. So we will definitely repeat that research because, again, I think we were really early. What's probably not in question is the desire of marketers to be more relevant, to, you know, think beyond age and gender and have deeper audience definitions, to think of all of their television and video advertising as something that drives performance, you know, that's performant. That is a trend, those are trends that will continue. But this new lens, I think, of things like privacy and consumer data access just sort of throws a lot of this stuff in question. So we need to be really careful about how we proceed now, so that we don't sort of lose our privileges to that data.
I mean, that's an interesting thing, because you hear, when we talk to people about this, we hear a lot of sort of individual stories of people saying, gosh, you know, I hope TV doesn't wind up being, you know, having that, the equivalent of when, you know, the shoes you clicked on 2 months ago follow you around the internet and all the privacy concerns. But are you hearing that on a more corporate level? In other words, like, you hear it, you know, people relating, you know, in their own lives, but is this sort of a bigger, like, okay, yeah, we do, as we move forward with this, actually really do need to be concerned with this?
So the level of concern around the notion of privacy is relatively high, but I'm not sure that it's been entirely internalized to what it really should mean, which is, how do we think about delivering to consumers something that they value and feel good about and feel more in control of? So privacy compliance is a common conversation, but the spirit of privacy and how you really change how you collect consumers' data, how you talk to them about how you collect their data, how you message to them. I'm not sure that the average brand is there yet, right? It's more about compliance than it is about philosophically how do we change how we behave and how we interact with consumers to make them feel more comfortable and confident that when they're transacting with us, it's all good. Like, it's okay. We trust they can trust us and they can feel good about the experience and that we are good stewards of their data and their experience.